What's up, internet? I'm Jessica Lesaca, and welcome to Weak Side. Yeah. So today we're starting off this week's episode with a really sad story. The time has come for all Toys R Us kids to finally grow up.
No! No! No!
It was announced that the toy retailer chain filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy and will be closing all their remaining US stores. Which is a good thing for toy collectors because they'll be liquidating all the remaining assets. So go get them, guys. Go get them, Tiger. After 70 years in business, many of us have very fond memories of browsing the aisles of Toys R Us. And with that being said, I wanted to dedicate one of my favorite songs growing up to my favorite childhood toy store. I don't wanna grow up, I'm a Toys R Us kid. They got a million toys at Toys R Us that I can play with. From bikes to trains to video games. It's the biggest toy store there is, Jewish! I don't wanna grow up, cause baby, if I did, I wouldn't be a Toys R Us kid.
Bravo! Bravo!
While a blizzard blew through Boston, some footage was taken of a man dressed as Elsa from Frozen helping out a Boston PD wagon out of the snow. And the footage is nothing short of Disney magic. Check it out. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway. An open casting call in search of the new host for the reboot of Blue's Clues launched, and one notable contestant is none other than the great John Cena. And former Blue's Clues host Steve didn't take too kindly to this casting choice. He challenged John Cena to a fight to the death. Just kidding, he challenged John Cena to a fight to take back Blue's house. So what do you guys think? Who's gonna be the next host of Blue's Clues, Blue's Clues, Blue's Clues? United Airlines is in the doghouse, literally. The airline mistakenly shipped a Kansas-bound German Shepherd to Japan instead, because, you know, Kansas, Japan, sound the same, spelled the same, right? Right? And not only that, the airline, which I will most likely never fly again because of this, forced a woman traveling with two children and her dog to put her dog in the overhead bin rather than the seat in front of her, which is standard practice for airplanes. The woman fought with the flight attendant to keep her dog in the seat in front of her, but was assured that the dog would be okay in the overhead bin. Which makes no sense to me because there's no airflow in the overhead bin. So 3 hours later when they landed, and after 2 hours of hearing the dog bark in the overhead bin, they opened the dog crate and the dog had passed away. So sad. They even tried to resuscitate the dog afterwards to no avail. If I was that woman, I would have lost my beep. It was later revealed that 75% of all dog deaths that occur on airplanes are United Airlines. So hey, maybe United just shouldn't deal with dogs. So if you have a dog, don't fly United. There is some silver lining to all this. Louisiana Senator John Kennedy introduced the Woof Act, which would basically fine airlines for forcing people to put their animals in the overhead bin. So with all that said, who let the dogs out? Not United. That's it for me and the unofficial musical episode. I'm Jessica Lesaca. Stay saucy. Bye, bye, bye. Shred the gnar, bruh.